Greetings, St. Isaacs and family. Anyone remember Joni Mitchell? If you do, you probably know the song that says, "You don't know what you've got till it's gone." As Catholics, we always thought we'd have Mass any day of the week, didn't we? And a choice of times on a Sunday. The Mass has been so available to us that maybe we never appreciated what we had. Now, I've heard of people crying because they're locked out of the church. Mother Teresa put a cross in every one of her chapels with "I thirst" written beside it, the dying words of Jesus on the cross. But if he was thirsty, why didn't he drink when the soldier offered him cheap wine? Mother Teresa thought it was because Jesus was thirsting for souls, for our salvation. In these times, we may not be able to go to worship Jesus in church, but that doesn't mean Jesus will not come to us. In the book of Revelation, chapter 3, verse 20, Jesus says, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him and eat with him, and he with me." Our supermarkets may have been cleared with people hoarding food for the crisis. But when you sit down to eat, are you inviting Jesus in? We may be in quarantine, but Jesus is not. He may live in the church, but he lives in your home too, if you invite him. So tell him, "Jesus, I cannot come to your house today, but please come into mine."
You stand at the door, and the door of our hearts, Lord, we adore from the start. So enter, enter. I'm calling your name. Your mercy desire, the Spirit's mighty flame. You follow, follow through the years. To be filled with your strength and victory, I need to be rebuilt. I thirst to love you and be loved by you. I thirst and adore you. Your love for me is true. Oh, I thirst for you. I feel useless to the world. I don't need more. love. I'm sure, Lord, I'm sure you're above. Our loneliness, rejection, wearing our souls.